स्टूडेंट्स, व्हाट इज इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक स्पेक्ट्रम? सो इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक स्पेक्ट्रम इज अ रेंज ऑफ लाइट. लाइट कंसिस्ट ऑफ सेवरल वेव्स, सो वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग दैट इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक स्पेक्ट्रम. सो इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक स्पेक्ट्रम, दिस लाइट कैन ट्रैवल थ्रू वैक्यूम. दे हैव ऑल द सेम स्पीड इन एयर. यू आर ऑलरेडी अवेयर व्हाट इज द स्पीड ऑफ लाइट, 3×10⁸ meters per second, and they are all transverse waves. Okay, so this is the electromagnetic spectrum. You can see on the lower frequency side we have radio waves, and microwaves have slightly more frequency than radio waves, and from microwaves infrared has slightly more frequency, and visible light has more frequency than infrared, and with the visible light compared to visible light, more frequency is there for ultraviolet, and compared to ultraviolet, more frequency is there for x-rays, and compared to x-rays, more frequency is there for gamma rays. So in this order the frequency is arranged. So at the lower most frequency is radio waves, then comes microwaves, infrared, visible light, ultraviolet light, x-rays, then comes gamma rays. Now this is arranged. You can see over here the frequency decreases and the wavelength increases. You can see this, the frequency over here decreases and the wavelength increases. Here what happens is that in x-rays and gamma rays the frequency increases and the wavelength decreases. You can see this wave. The frequency increases but the wavelength decreases. Here it is the opposite. Visible light, infrared, microwaves and radio waves, the frequency decreases and the wavelength increases. You can see this. This is plotted for you to understand. Okay, and this diagram also. The electromagnetic spectrum consists of radio waves. You can see over here radio waves, microwaves, infrared is a small portion, infrared portion. Visible light is comparatively to infrared is much smaller, you can see. And ultraviolet is also smaller. Then comes x-rays and then comes gamma rays. Okay, so on the lower side, the lowest frequency would be radio waves, and on the higher side the higher frequency would be gamma rays. Okay, so this is the electromagnetic spectrum. Electromagnetic spectrum consists of radio waves, microwaves, infrared, ultraviolet rays, x-rays, gamma rays. Now the visible light you can see is much smaller. The visible light is divided into violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, red. You can see over here, this same is over here. This much portion only is drawn down so that you can see properly. Violet, you can see violet, then indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange and red. So this visible light, the same is shown on the top and the same is shown in bottom, consists of these spectrums. So below this spectrum comes infrared. Infrared, after infrared comes microwaves, and from after microwaves comes radio waves. The main properties of radio waves, microwaves and infrared is that they are of low frequency, their energy is also low, and their wavelength is long wavelength. Radio waves wavelength is comparatively much longer than microwaves. Microwaves wavelength is comparatively much longer than infrared. Okay, this is infrared. After infrared we can see visible light is a small portion. it is in between to 10 raised to minus 5 and 10 raised to minus 7. Then we have ultraviolet rays, then we have X-rays, and then we have gamma rays. Ultraviolet rays are rays of short wavelength, high energy and high frequency, you can see over here. So this gamma rays has more high frequency as compared to X-rays, and X-rays have high frequency when compared to ultraviolet ray. This radio waves, microwaves and infrared are non-ionizing. You can see it is non-ionizing, and ultraviolet rays, X-rays and gamma rays are ionizing. So you can see the wavelength over here. It is much more longer. When you see radio waves, microwaves and infrared, the wavelength is much more longer. And when it comes over here, ultraviolet rays, X-rays and gamma rays, you can see the wavelength is much more short. It decreases because as the frequency increases, the wavelength decreases. And this is comparatively of high energy and high frequency. Ultraviolet rays, X-rays and gamma rays are of high energy and of high frequency. So you can see this graph over here, frequency decreases and wavelength increases. From here to here, this section, the frequency decreases. This is the lowest, radio wave is the lowest frequency, and the wavelength from here it increases to gamma rays. So electromagnetic spectrum, this is the brief description about the electromagnetic spectrum. In case you need to remember the visible light, we can remember this abbreviation. It's VIBGYOR, VIBGYOR. So you can remember this: violet, indigo, blue, green, yellow, orange, red. In this way, the electromagnetic spectrum is divided. Okay, so we have discussed the spectrum. Now, to a human eye, this visible light is constituting of, see, you can see violet is on the higher frequency side, red is on the lowermost frequency side. So ultra denotes more frequency, this you have to keep in mind, and infra denotes less frequency. Now we will see what are the uses. Uses are primarily asked. So what are the uses we will see of electromagnetic spectrum? We will be seeing what are the uses of the waves. So infrared waves, what is it is used? Infrared waves, you can see it is used in remote control, heaters and night vision cameras, equipment and so on and so forth. These are only limited examples for you to understand where it is used. Now microwaves are used in ovens, mobile phones, satellite signals. These are some of the examples where microwaves are used. Radio waves are long distance communication used for broadcasting and communication. These are used primarily for satellite signals. Okay, and now ultraviolet is primarily used in fluorescent lamps. In fluorescent lamps, the higher the frequency, the dangerous the UV rays. They are ionizing. This is the harmful effect of the negative side of ultraviolet rays. Now X-rays are used to check the bone, broken bone, then for security checks. The negative side again remains that when the frequency is higher, the X-rays are dangerous because they are ionizing. Gamma rays is used for cancer treatment and checking the broken pipes underground. If certain pipes are broken, gamma rays are emitted on the ground so that we can check there are any broken pipes inside the earth. So here also the negative side is that higher the frequency, dangerous are the gamma rays, they are ionizing. This is the harmful side effect. The positive side is that it is used for sterilizing food and medical equipment. So this is the positive side of gamma rays. Gamma rays are used for cancer treatment, checking the broken pipes underground, sterilizing food and medical equipment. Okay, the negative side is that it is highly dangerous, the gamma rays, increasing frequency because these rays are ionizing.
Thank you.